The State Minister of Finance, Henry Musasizi, today faced the Budget Committee of Parliament and officially unpacked the 2023-2024 financial year budget framework paper of 49.9 trillion shillings.
By Uganda shillings, 2.54 trillion from Uganda shillings, 25.402 trillion in financial year 2022-2023 to Uganda shillings, 22.86 trillion in financial year 2023-2024.
However, committee members lashed out at the Minister for gross budget indiscipline, accusing the Minister of prioritizing releases to unbudgeted items, hence making implementations of the current budget difficult.
But an agency called Nagric, which is supposed to breed those livestock and farmers buy from your PDM, has been given 10%. So, is it about money or is it about your own priority, which is not in the budget? And at the end, these monies are not received. And two, issues of financial problems are not only owned by finance. They do their work on our behalf.
Some lawmakers were left wondering why the security budget has remained unchanged despite receiving lion's share funding in the past financial years on grounds of procuring classified security equipment.
We were taken to hotel by the then Minister of Finance, Honorable Bahati, and requested us to okay a continued defense expenditure annual of 1 trillion for special acquisition of a special defense equipment.
However, Ramadan Gobi, the Secretary to the Treasury, pointed out that the medium-term expenditure framework that highlights budget projections indicates that in the coming years, the security budget is going to be reduced following the completion of the controversial classified project.
The funding for governance and security is reducing. It's going to reduce from 7.16 trillion of this financial year, we are to 6.8. So there is a reduction, and it is because of, among others.
Musasizi explained that a number of priorities have been set on including peace and security, maintenance of both tarmac and Maram roads, construction of power substations and transmission lines, and rehabilitation of the meter gauge railway and development of the standard gauge railway.
Rehabilitation of the meter gauge railway and development of the standard gauge railway. This will connect with the improvements in water transport and the aviation school.
MPs have challenged the government for allocating fewer funds to sectors that drive development of the country, like tourism and agriculture, yet government considered them as key priorities in the National Development Program 3.
The area that would bring in more money to the economy to address areas of expenditure is fundamentally ignored, which is tourism.
But what we see money being allocated to some of particularly key priority projects like roads, and these are very critical things down there.
Legislators also called for prioritization of health facilities across the country.
They needed 18 billion for the hospital to fully operate, and it's a very nice hospital. I would want to encourage members of parliament. It's standard at international level.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news at parliament.